حور العين تناديني فدعيني أماه دعيني، حور العين تناديني فدعيني أماه دعيني. لا تبكي دموعك يا أمي عند دربي لا لن تثنيني.
بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. My respectable brothers and sisters, fathers as well as mothers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you, bless you and your family this dunya and the hereafter. And please do not forget at the end of this video to click the subscription button of our channel. Inshallah, you will be updated inshallah on weekly basis, inshallah, or monthly, inshallah, for the nation. Brothers and sisters in the deen, our topic today is al-bukha, weeping, crying. Crying is part of us naturally, as human. Allah said in the Quran, Surah Al-Najm, He said, وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَدْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who causes laughter and grief or sadness. In other words, He is the one who makes you cry or laugh. He is the provider of happiness, joy, sorrow, or sadness. He is Allah who does that for different reasons. So the question I want you to ask yourself is, have you ever cried? Of course, yes, you have. But for what reason did you cry? Why did you cry? Listen to this hadith. Or before we get to the hadith, Yazid bin Maysara, he said people cry for different reasons. Some of us, you may cry because of joy, min al-farah. You know, when someone, they're happy, we have what we call tears of joy, isn't it? And also as well, we have tears of sorrow. When someone is going through problem, pain, they lost someone and etc., they cry. And faza, right? Someone may weep out of fear. Someone may weep as well out of pain. And someone may weep out of gratitude and etc. And someone may cry and weep out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So which one is yours? The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, according to Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, this hadith, it's on the authority of Muslim. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, عينان لا تمسهما النار. Two eyes, or type of eyes, two. These eyes will never be touched by the fire. The Jahannam, the hellfire, these eyes will never be touched by the hellfire. Never. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, take these brothers and sisters. Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah said, وَمَا يَنْتِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَىٰ إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٍ يُوحَىٰ. He does not speak on his own, say things that he wants to say just because he wants to say them. No. Whatsoever he sees, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now he is telling you, he said, عَيْنَانْ لَا تَمُسُّهُمَ النَّارِ. Two eyes, type of eyes, will never be touched by the hellfire. One of them, or the first, he said, عَيْنٌ بَكَتْ مِنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. The eye that shed tears, cry for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah. And the second, عين باتت تحرس في سبيل الله. The eye that spends the night in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In other words, the eye that stands in the night, the person that spends the night worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the eye will not see the Jahannam. We not dwell in Jahannam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst those who possess those eyes, Ya Arhamar Rahimeen. Brothers and sisters in the day, some of us, when we lose our beloved ones, when we lose our money, etc., we cry, we yell. But whenever they tell us about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our hearts become so bold, we don't cry. When last did you cry out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When last? When? There's a question you need to ask yourself all the time. A question you need to ask yourself. And that's why Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, لأن أدمع من خشية الله أحب إلي من أن أتصدق بألف دينار. He said, for me to cry out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more preferred than I spend 1,000 dinar as sadaqah for the sake of Allah. What about you? Ask yourself, when they recite the Quran, when they talk about Allah, we are there, some of us, we are laughing here and there. Have you ever sat down in your life thinking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the day you're going to be standing in front of Allah, naked, barefooted, uncircumcised, faced with the questions of Allah? What about in the grave as well? The day we're going to put you, or they're going to put you in your grave, going to answer to the questions of the angels coming to you, and then you cry. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, سَبْعَ يُذِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ يَوْمَ لَا ذِلَّ إِلَّا ذِلُّ. 7 categories of people will be under the shade of Allah يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, when there will be no shade except His. And one of them is a man who sits isolatedly. He sits by himself. ذكر الله. He remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala خالياً, while being isolated from the people. ففادت عيناه. And he cries out of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will be under the shade of Allah yawm al-qiyamah. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, he used to go to the cemetery. He would stand by the grave and cry, 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 until his beard become wet. And he said, Ya Amir al-Mu'mineen, they talk, speak about Jahannam, the breach. You don't cry the way you cry when you stand by the grave. Why? He said, سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول. He said, I heard the message of Allah, may the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say. He said, إن القبر أول منزل من المنازل الآخر من منازل الآخرة. He said, the grave, it is the first station amongst the stations of the hereafter. فإن نجا من, if someone saved or being protected from the torment, from the grave, فما بعده أيسر, what comes next is easier. وإن لم ينجح من, if he or she is not saved from the torment of the grave, then فما بعده أشد, what comes after that would be more difficult. May Allah save us from the torment of the hereafter. Here is the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came to Ibn Mas'ud, he said, اقرأ علي القرآن. He said, Ibn Mas'ud, read the Qur'an to me. Then Ibn Mas'ud said, Ya Rasulullah, how can I recite the Qur'an for you while this Qur'an is being revealed unto you? And he said, إني أحب أن أسمعه من غيري. I would love to hear the Qur'an from somebody else. So read the Qur'an to me. Ibn Mas'ud said, he said, فقرأت عليه سورة النساء. He said, I started reciting سورة النساء to him until when I arrived at this ayah. Listen to the ayah where Allah said, فكيف إذا جئنا من كل أمة بشهيد وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا. Allah said, what about when I will bring you the day of judgment I will bring, first of all, he said, I will bring your ummah to be, to testify against other ummah, other nations. And I will bring you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to testify, to be a witness. Against your ummah as well, to give testimony. Allah. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Ibn Mas'ud, hasbuk, enough. He said, when I turned, I looked at the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِذَا عَيْنَاهُ تَذْرِفَانِ I saw him crying. So what about you? It's time for you to reflect and ponder again. It's time for you to take heed and soften your heart. Turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Cry to him. Whether it's in dua, whether in your sujood, wherever you are, cry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Your Lord is a forgiving God. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us and grant all of us al-Jannah. جزاكم الله خير الجزاء كيف اسماعيل والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.